Hi, welcome to financialexpress.com budget specials. We have with us Nabin from KPMG. He's an expert on the oil and gas sector, and he will tell us about how our petrol and diesel prices and LPG prices will go up based on how the government decides its policy. Welcome to the show, Nabin.
Thank you.
So, Nabin, petrol and diesel prices are now decontrolled. We wait for LPG prices to be announced. Aviation fuel prices are announced. So, what should be the next reform on the government's agenda? What is on top of your wish list?
Right. So, as far as the pricing is concerned, the one thing that I must actually compliment the present government is that they have actually done pretty well to decontrol the prices and actually bring some degree of sanity and reality to the segment. The other thing that needs to be done now after petrol and diesel is the kerosene. Although it's going to impact the social sector, it's going to impact the rural sector, but at the end of the day, we have to come closer to reality. So that's the next big thing that I would expect the government to consider, maybe in a phased manner, but important for us to get into that reality check.
Aren't kerosene prices already going up by 25 paisa per fortnight or something? There was a policy around this.
Yes. So oil prices, kerosene prices are getting revised, but still the bigger concern is the leakage of the subsidy, which at least has been captured in case of LPG and diesel for that matter.
So apart from pricing, what other fundamental reforms do you think are needed in this sector?
So when we talk about oil and gas as a sector, you know, it is very important, and for India, which actually relies on import of oil and gas by, you know, for more than 80% of its requirement. And if you just look at the import bill, it's around like 24% of our import bill is for crude oil. So it's very important for us to make sure that for the purpose of energy security of the country, we focus on the domestic production as well as on the overseas acquisition of oil blocks. So these are the two important areas that should be focused upon. Recently, we saw discovered small fields auction come in, and of course there was interest, but what I at least personally feel that at the price of $53-$54 that we have right now for crude oil, it is important for the government to give, you know, some tax incentives also to producers to make it viable for them. And that is something which is going to bring in a lot of interest. So that's one important thing, tax incentive for crude oil producers. The other important thing that I would at least think through is the minimum alternate tax for the oil producers. That has been a matter of concern for quite some time. And in the recent past, you know, right now we are talking about the Ind AS implementation. So the first year, there are going to be major adjustments that are going to happen, and the MAT liability is likely to go up. So that has been the other concern for the oil and gas players, and they definitely want that the MAT should at least go, or the carry forward of the MAT credit should not be limited to the 10 years that we have right now, and it should be made unlimited. As far as the overseas acquisition are concerned, definitely the government can come and play a role in making sure that there's the support that, you know, we see in case of China and other countries, which, you know, where the government comes in to support the acquisition. If that happens, I think we are there.
Gas pricing is a political issue. The government has tried to resolve it. They've introduced new norms for gas pricing. And along with that, the Narendra Modi government also wants to make natural gas more accessible to all households, whether it be through the LPG cylinder route or through the piped gas route. So what is your view on gas pricing and on gas distribution?
So if we look at the way things have progressed on account of LPG, there has been considerable progress that has been made. And my sense is that we are actually moving in the right direction. What is needed is to actually start looking at the city gas distribution, because that actually takes, you know, once you set up the network, the entire issue of logistics of making sure that the LPG cylinder reaches a household is taken care of. Everything becomes online. So that is the sector or the segment that needs to be focused upon more and more. If we can build in more like city gas distribution networks into city, that's something which is going to definitely help. And if we really want to progress on that, if we really want to support that, definitely some degree of incentives are required. So, say currently when you talk about cross-country gas pipelines, there is this 35 AD deduction or an accelerated depreciation that is allowed, which is not available for a city gas distribution entity. So, if that could be brought in for city gas distribution, definitely this, you know, the LPG or the gas reaching household will become much more easier.
And one final question, lots of people, each time the petrol price goes up, all opposition parties will typically say that taxes account for a huge portion of the petrol and diesel price. Do you see that changing in the near future?
So, yes, it does. And I am expecting, you know, I am hopeful that the taxes on the petrol and diesel would actually come down so that we see lower prices for the petroleum.
Thank you for joining us, Nabin.
Thank you.
Thank you for joining us. Do watch financialexpress.com for more budget updates.